these people? With your host, Marianne Lockwood.
Hello, and welcome to Nice People. This week we'll feature entertainment, volunteerism, and even show you some real-life heroes. We'll try to keep up with a whirlwind schedule of Up With People, a talented group of youngsters sharing a message of brotherhood. In California, you'll see the fine work being done by some junior hospital volunteers. And you'll find out how another volunteer group is helping to preserve the natural beauty of the Appalachian Trail. But first, a Nice People extra, as we show you some absolute proof that the spirit of heroism still exists in America. It was a rainy day in Tucson when KVOA's Tom Tankery set out to tape the weather. This is what he found.
I was shooting people trapped in a car. As they pulled out, you notice two girls who are trying to cross the street. The smaller one loses her footing. The other girl tries to keep her, to get her to the shore, but she can't do it because of the force of the water. I didn't see anyone coming to their aid, and figuring that I might be their only chance, I dropped the camera and went in after them. Two other gentlemen who were also there, sort of behind and off to my side, also did the same thing. I came in behind them and grabbed the smaller of the two girls who were in the wash. The larger or the older of the two girls slipped out first and went down into the ditch, and at that point, we just could not hold the smaller girl at all, and she slipped out of our hands and went down the ditch. And it would have been a very, very tragic story had not someone further down that ditch witnessed our predicament and acted very quickly. Had a rope in the back of his pickup truck, had several people help him, tied the rope around his waist, and dove in to the rushing water. He had gotten both of them out. He caught the one, and then when we finally let go of the smaller one, he was there and free to grab her also as she came down. And if it wasn't for him, I don't think either one of them would have made it.
Nice People salutes these real live heroes: Carl Hoag, Bob Batts, Ed Finney, Ralph Randisano, and Tom Tankery. Some rather dramatic evidence that you can always find nice people to come to the rescue. When we come back, you'll see how volunteers are making conditions nicer in a California hospital and along the Appalachian Trail. Kids who care. There are still plenty of them around, as we found out on a Nice People trip to California. The staff and patients here at the University of Southern California Medical Center are indeed lucky. This teaching hospital has the largest junior volunteer program in the country at its disposal. Some 250 young people, mostly Latinos, spend some 5,000 hours a month helping, just for the sake of helping.
Well, I think it's very important that the community and the world at large know that there are fine young people in East Los Angeles. Too often, the image of the East Los Angeles youth is only of drugs, of gang wars, and that seems to get in the headlines. And here we have an example of very fine young people who are from East Los Angeles. This is a great big impersonal institution, threatening and frightening to patients. And I think the friendly young people who are basically there to help the patients make a big difference. It's marvelous. It really is.
Some 2,000 miles away, another group of volunteers devote their time to a different type of project. So lace up your hiking boots for a walk along the Appalachian Trail. A sunny Saturday afternoon on a wooded hillside in southwest Virginia, and a rather ragtag group of people make their way toward a rendezvous with weeds and brush. These people are not would-be farmers. In fact, they don't even own the land. They are volunteers on America's longest footpath.
We're the Roanoke Appalachian Trail Club, and the Appalachian Trail Conference is an umbrella organization that consists of, I think, 63 clubs that maintain the Appalachian Trail between Maine and Georgia. There's over 2,000 miles of the Appalachian Trail, and our particular club, we maintain 120 miles of the Appalachian Trail in this area.
All right, start over again.
Though it's difficult to estimate, best guesses are that between 2 and 4 million people hike at least some part of the Appalachian Trail annually. And when it's time to cut brush, repaint a blaze, or pack out garbage, Trail Club volunteers are there to do it. Of course, the question is, why?
I like to do it, and I think that we like to get out in the open. I feel close to nature some way or other.
Well, I just guess I just like the woods. I've been kind of doing this all my life. Seems to me like I've been doing it all my life. I just like to be, like these mountains. I like to get out and walk in them. And I'm nostalgic about this Appalachian Trail. I want to see it continued all the way from Maine to Georgia.
It's fun. We enjoy getting out in the woods. We enjoy our company as a group of folks who like the outdoors, and that's the reason.
I think we, you know, all have a common bond and love for the outdoors and love for nature and love of the land.
And so the never-ending work continues. Scattered among this group is a college math teacher, a church secretary, several retirees, and a business executive. Diverse people working with 60,000 others to help preserve a footpath in the wilderness. Coming up, Nice People salutes Up With People. Stay with us for that entertaining and uplifting story.
For whatever you want to know about any kind of pet.
You ever heard a guinea pig talk?
Or a horse, cat, dog, rabbit, reptile, bird, or goat. Watch Cable News Network for advice from the best vet yet.
I'm Dr. Steve Kritzik with People and Pets and Puppies.
Look for People and Pets on Cable News Network. If you don't already have CNN, contact your cable operator to get it. Because CNN is the news.
George Krucher is a fireman in New York City, where at any moment an alarm calls him into a life-threatening situation.
Your chest hurts. All your senses hurt. That's your job.
Time and again, he tests his skills and dedication. He's one of the American professionals. Meet him Monday night on Superstation WTBS. It's business as usual for Rock Hudson. The Doris Day is offering some stiff competition in Lover Come Back, Tuesday night on Superstation WTBS.
If you watched the Super Bowl last year, you saw a halftime performance by a dynamic group called Up With People. They carry their message of brotherhood all over the world. And Norma Brooks says you can't find a nicer bunch wherever you go.
Up with people. You meet them wherever you go. Up with people. They're the best kind of folks we know.
People. There are 4 billion of us inhabiting this small planet. We're very diverse. We come from countless cultures, races, and religions. And yet we have a common bond. We're all part of the family of mankind. Up With People is dedicated to strengthening this bond and building bridges of understanding between all peoples of the world. And what better way than through the universal language of music?
Every year, some 500 young people between the ages of 17 and 25 began an exciting adventure of travel and work with Up With People, not only as performers, but as ambassadors of goodwill. They come from over 20 countries and almost all 50 states, and their backgrounds are as diverse as the people they meet and perform for. Up With People was founded by Blanton Belk in Tucson, Arizona during the 60s. The hope was that the unrest of the youth at that time could be channeled in a more positive direction.
We give them experiences that so challenge them that it brings out things in them that they didn't know were there before. And says they say to themselves, hey, I can do things I didn't know I could do. And we hope and we believe from studying the 6,000 who graduated from the program that it helps them become bigger people, people with a global perspective, and people that really know how to get involved and to help other people. We have 1,000 young people a month who are being interviewed to spend a year with us. And just to make one thing clear is that even though they do a big musical show, we don't audition these young people, we interview them, because we want to give them an educational experience, and we want to find those that are motivated that can really take in this educational experience. So we're looking for the intellectual capacities, and we're looking for that motivational thing that tells us, hey, here's a young person, if they have this kind of years experience, we believe they'll do something with it that will affect their community in a positive way, affect their country in a positive way, and affect their friends in a positive way.
Beginning 14 years ago, Up With People Cast have carried their positive attitude to 2,500 cities in 47 countries. Over 7,000 two-hour shows have been performed before 6.5 million people. In addition, another 30,000 informal shows have been enjoyed by millions in prisons, universities, and hospitals. The cast have shared their enthusiasm and excitement with presidents and kings, farmers and factory workers, with people from nearly every walk of life.
We're getting some response around the world that's very significant. We just had two of our cast do 45 cities throughout Mexico, and Mrs. Lopez Portillo, the wife of the president, wrote me a letter, and she said, when situation not what it really could be between our countries, meaning North America and Mexico, nobody has kept communications open and built such permanent friendships as the students and Up With People, and please tell my friends in North America that.
Everywhere the cast go, they receive praise and appreciation, and this is understandable. As soon as the students come into a community, they open themselves to the people, not only through their music, but through the personal relationships they form. Deep bonds of friendship are developed with the host families in each area. All cast members and staff are housed in individual homes in a community. By the end of the year, students will live with 80 families throughout the world. The Guytons were one of the host families in Atlanta. Bob Guyton is the president of the Bank of the South, which co-sponsored Up With People in the city, along with Georgia Pacific.
They are just very fantastic people. They bring to Atlanta a real culture that we don't have here that's exciting. They expand and give of that culture to the families that are here and to the high schools and to the nursing homes, wherever they performed. And they bring a real positive outlook to life. I think that's contagious. We've thoroughly enjoyed it. We've enjoyed each other. We're going to miss them when they leave.
It's always a little bit, you know, kind of sad, because when you get to know somebody and you get to know them close and you just feel part of the family and you talk a lot about a lot of things, you know, you kind of feel really close to them, and it's always sad to leave them, and you know, you don't know if you're gonna see them again, so it's pretty hard.
And Up With People, you know, saying goodbye is a big part of it, because we do it so much, we're always on the move, but still it doesn't get any easier. As time goes on, it's always tough to leave somebody that you've met and gotten to know.
And each family has something special to offer us. Each single family has a little something special, and it's always sad to leave.
If all of us had the positive outlook and the vivaciousness that they have, this would be a great world. It really would.
Each other.
The Up With People shows are indeed entertaining and uplifting, but the main thrust of the organization is building unity and understanding.
When the cast came through my town, they came through and I spent a day with them, just watching what they were doing and getting involved with the students there. And you could see the unity that they had in between each other, and that's what really caught my attention and what really made me want to be a part of that, wanted me to be a part of the unity that I saw in them.
During the course of the year, there are five casts traveling the world. The cast members meet and live with all classes of people, from government officials and community leaders to just people. This provides an atmosphere for communication and an interchange of ideas that promotes greater understanding.
I've learned a lot about a lot of people, and we've been in Venezuela. I've learned a lot about the culture down there, but more than anything, I've learned a lot about myself and how to deal with different life situations, how to handle stress, be a little more patient, a little more tolerant, and just mostly, like I said, a lot about myself and how to handle life.
To be part of Up With People, you learn to live with so many people, 24 hours a day. You're on the road constantly for 11 months with a slight break in the middle with 100 people, 24 hours a day. It's one of the toughest things I've had to do in my life so far. I know I'm going to be a step ahead of what I would have been when I go into college next year.
The schedule these young people keep is tough. Up early, rehearsing, setting up for performances, visiting schools, hospitals, and prisons. During their stay in Atlanta, they visited numerous schools. One of those was Garden Hills Elementary. This school had added interest to the cast because of its international flavor. The day the cast visited the school, they were having an international field day, enjoying games and dances from other countries. The students from Garden Hills had the opportunity to socialize with the Up With People students during lunch, and they really got involved during the performance later. After the show, the cast geared up for another one at Northside High School. Also, they participated in an international banquet. Several of the cast members prepared their favorite dishes from their native lands to add to the incredible spread of food. Young people from other countries meeting young people, hopefully bridging the gap between peoples of the world.
Say it ever happened, we had students from the People's Republic of China, the USSR, with the North Americans and the Africans and the Asians, and they had a year in an apolitical, non-sectarian organization like Up With People where they could build something. Maybe it would sow a little seed of future peace in the world. That's a dream I have for it.
Another part of the educational aspect of this organization is the students' exposure to hospitals and treatment centers. In Atlanta, they toured and entertained at the Shepherd Spinal Clinic. This center deals in treatment and rehabilitation of people with severe spinal cord injuries. Lindsay Hopkins, the president of the board of directors for Shepherd, was quite instrumental in bringing Up With People to Atlanta.
I think it's great. I want my two daughters to join. I believe that strongly in it. I think it's a very broadening, wonderful experience for young people. And they come from so many places and so many walks of life. And I just think that it would give my daughters and other young people a broadening experience. So I'm all for the involvement.
The involvement the cast members had with the patients at the Shepherd Center was heartwarming. There, the physically fit and active students were face-to-face with people, some their own ages, with limited mobility.
This center takes care of people who can't walk, can't move really, and that's what's really important to me. So it really hit me hard, the incredible job that they're doing here and what they're doing for people who are incapacitated. They can't move in a lot of ways. I just thought of myself and how it would be difficult, a difficult thing to deal with, and how important it is to have a center like this to really help people.
There's
It's a spirit in everybody that needs to be expressed. And I think one thing Up With People does is sometimes touches that spirit in people and turns it on and brings it out. And they say to themselves, hey, I could achieve that dream I've been thinking about. I think there are millions of dreams in people that ought to be brought to life. I think if they were, I think we'd have a creative blossoming in the world, and I think people would do things for each other and families and cities and states and countries in the world that would be very, very significant to take humanity forward.
We've come a long, long way now, and nobody knows just how far, just how far we still have to go. It's becoming so plain now that our paths are going to cross. It's everyone's game, it's everyone's game, or it's everyone's loss.
Well, it used to be a question.
I wouldn't trade what I've been doing for the past, actually the past 2 years, for anything in the world. I think just looking back to where I was before I started and where I am now, it's been great.
And who is first?
We can't lose heart, can't lose our nerve. There's too many who haven't been served. The table is set, we must take our place.
I just, you know, look at Up With People as the chance to really do something for everybody else, and at the same time open my mind to different things, different ways of thinking and living and reacting, you know, so.
Can't lose heart, can't lose our nerve. There's too many who haven't been served. The table is round, there's plenty of space for face to face.
If you could see the 100 of us from 18 different countries work together, why can't the world work together the same way we do?
Those lyrics sum up what Nice People is all about, those looking for a chance to serve. If you know someone like that, we'd like to know about them too. So write a letter to Nice People, 1050 Techwood Drive Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia, 30318. Next week, we'll visit one of America's friendliest restaurants, and we'll also learn about the worldwide service project being undertaken by rock star Bob Weir. I'm Marianne Laughlin, and please join us next week for the stories of more Nice People.